What? Eddie Chan needs a heavy bag, but he has no place to hang it?
Oopa. Alrighty. How are we looking? I'm on the water today. A little charcoal filter. Keeps me fresh. It's not always alcohol that gets you buzzed, right? Sometimes it's just life. Today was a good day. Good routine. The bit you saw me do at the start was with that O2 trainer from Bass Rutan that he gave Connor, and I robbed it. I was left behind. I had pneumonia when I was a kid. I was like 14. I was hospitalized for 2 weeks with a bad case of pneumonia. So I was just sitting there and I thought, you know what, just drag that back out. It won't do me any harm, straighten up the lungs a little bit. And it works. It's good. And then the other thing is the Bates method, that eye exercises. My eyesight's starting to fall off a cliff, and in the evening they get very tired. I just don't even bother reading stuff, if you know what I mean. Like, I've got to the stage where if I'm in a restaurant and it's a low light restaurant, I'll just say, yeah, I'll just have whatever he's having. You know? But reason being is, one is you're looking at a screen, but two, you're always looking at a phone. You're always looking short. You're never looking far. And the lens on the eye molds to that shape. It's kind of like if I sit like this all the time, my body will just mold to that shape. But if I start to expand myself and move, it'll also expand and mold to that. So the Bates method is an old yoga system. When you think about it, when you were a kid, old people didn't have glasses, did they? They didn't, did they? Now everyone's got those plus two, plus three that you buy in pennies, and you get a pack of three for sixpence, you know? But the Bates method is basically exercising the atrophied muscle in the eye. You're looking up, down, sideways, diagonally, and then you're looking far, close, and you're straining the eye to start working again. And it works. But it's just putting it into my morning routine, because if it's not in a routine, you just won't do it enough. You got to do it every day. I just set the timer for 3 minutes and I do it. It's like a round of skipping or something. The boxing and slow-mo as well. I mean, I didn't do that on purpose. I pressed a button by mistake on the camera and just shot slow-mo. So I thought it looked in decent shape. So I just stuck it in. And a lot of it's down to, work ethic, training, people you train with. But then a lot of it's down to diet and food. And Tristan Kennedy's been looking after my diet for the last while. And I'm getting great strides from him. Great lad. He looks after Connor. But you really, really have to watch what you eat in order to be lean or to stay in shape. Good example of that was myself and the doc were in Dakar in Senegal one winter. And there was this guy, we used to go to the gym twice a week. And there was this guy, he was a big, huge belly on him. But he'd be always working like really super hard. He'd always have a broomstick and he'd be always swinging backwards and forwards, left, right. But he never, every year we went back, he was just the same fat guy. And then, we befriended each other. We started talking to each other after about 2 years. And then he invited us around to his house for dinner one night, and then we realised we were so fat. The fish got rolled in on a trolley, and he ate most of it. And that's it, back to this. Always there, you know? So really, what you're eating, and if something's planned out for you, it's a lot easier than, like anything. Plan to prepare, or prepare to fail. So if you've got a plan training-wise, you'll stick to it. If you've got a plan business-wise, you'll stick to it. If you've got a plan diet, you'll stick to it. And that's how things work. Same with, I remember Brian McCarthy, my old ninjutsu teacher, used to say, you wouldn't just go away on a weekend and not think about what you're going to bring with you. So why would you do that to anything else? Plan it. Think about it. Do the research. And go forward from there. Yeah, so shout outs. I wanted to give a shout out to Alan Lewis. He owns Lewis Motors. He just had a baby girl. Great guy. We clicked there. I was out with him there recently. He did us the McGregor Fast Jeep, and Connor's cars and stuff. But he's just a good all-round guy. Always looks after us. But he was watching my vlogs. He enjoyed them. So shout out to you. Probably up to your ears in it now with all babies, nappies and all that stuff. And what I wanted to talk about today was something that kind of, I was going to talk about it a while ago, but I just had more important things to talk about, to be honest with you. And phrases and the way they kind of start out of nothing and then all of a sudden it just becomes a general conversation and people don't even think about what they're saying before they say it. And I noticed that before I got back here, people were sending me messages and they were saying, stay safe. And I just thought it was bad advice. Stay safe. Safe from what? Just as a thing. Like, I would never have got to where I was if I always played safe. If I never took a chance. If I never stood outside the box. Or when opportunity knocked, said, yeah, I can do it, even though I didn't think I could. But I was never playing safe. I was never like, oh, well, I shouldn't go there or I shouldn't do this because, you know, maybe that mightn't work out. Never stay safe. But don't be reckless. You have to have courage. You have to have smarts. Stay smart would be a better line. Like the doc always used to say, train hard, train smart. Connor always says, stay ready. Stay smart, don't flap. Don't be reckless, but don't be safe. Like even ABBA weren't safe. You know, if you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. ABBA were taking chances. The most bubblegum 70s music ever. But they took a chance, you know? Don't be safe. Can you imagine if the whole world were just safe acting pussies? Can you imagine if somebody said to the first guy to ever sail off on a boat, don't go to the edge, you'll fall off, stay safe. We never would have gone anywhere, discovered anything. Could you imagine the first guy having jumped off the Eiffel Tower with a set of wings and killed himself? Do you know what I mean? Can you imagine the Wright brothers hadn't, you know, put together a plane and put a rudder on it and stabilized wings and flew the first ever plane? They weren't safe. They were never safe. So don't be safe, be smart. I think it's a better way to look at it. There was another interesting on characters. There was a piece, Paddy Hulihan sent me something the other day, and it got me. It just got me. And it was by Terry McMahon. He was on his podcast. I didn't know who he was, to be honest with you. He's an actor. And he read a piece into his phone. It was 15 minutes long, and it was called The Selfish Giant by Oscar Wilde. And it was absolutely one of the best pieces of storytelling I've ever heard. I got lost in it. I'm going to leave a link to it, you should watch it. Got lost in it. And then that was Oscar Wilde, and Oscar Wilde was a dandy. I mean, he wrote one of my other favorite children's stories, which was The Happy Prince. It's about a swallow and a statue to a dead prince. And the prince talks to the swallow. I remember watching it with my dad when I was a kid. They had a cartoon about it. And since then, the swallows have always been my favorite bird. And when I come out of the gym in the evening, they're just downstairs. You'll see them sometimes in the videos where they come back every year to the same spot. And the young come back and breed where their folks were and stuff like that. They're just a beautiful bird. I've always loved them. If I was ballsy enough, I'd have a swallow on my neck. But my mother would kill me. And then Oscar Wilde, there was another man that never took a chance, or did take a chance. Never played safe. Married with two kids, flamboyant, cut you down with his tongue. We're all in the gutter, except some of us are looking at the stars. He was gay in the wrong time. Went to prison for being with young men. And he was dead by 46. But he never played safe. And look what he created. You know, all the greats, anyone in business, any generals, any, like, John Laddie's been posting up pictures of Sean Kelly in the Paris-Roubaix, the Hell of the North, a fucking hard man's race, and they're not wearing a helmet. Safe. You know what I mean? And it's just bad advice. Don't be safe. Be brave. Be smart. And just fucking get out there and take a fucking chance. ABBA did. And look at them. Number one all over the place. That's it for today. I've got a lot of work to do at the moment. So I'm still going to do the vlogs, but I'm just going to have to squeeze them in. I can get a little routine in, and I can show you a little bit what I'm doing work-wise, and I'll get a few more little stories and put them in at the end. But I like this format. It's kind of like, here's my routine, here's a little story. Nothing too opinionated, just my story, you know. And we'll have it on tape. I'm shooting with a lens from Russia. That's probably older than most of you people. From 1982. A Helios 58mm f2 lens for you geeks out there. Has it got character? And it always took a chance. So that's it. Till the next one. Hare Krishna. We are all one. Namaste. Rafter.
If you change your mind, take a chance on the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down. If you're all alone, when the pretty birds have flown, honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me.